But we still need to decide, are we going to be an exchange, a state, state partnership exchange? That's the best case scenario now, probably, from an exchange standpoint. And of course, the exchange is this online shopping mart for insurance, where you can compare products side by side. And so that we're going to continue working on moving that project forward. Worst case, well, at the very least, Kansans will have an opportunity to buy on an exchange, but it may be a federal exchange.
So what do you have to do in terms of checking in with the administration and trying to understand the lay of the land here in Kansas before you can resume this work?
Well, for us to move to try to become a state partnership exchange, there has to be a declaration letter signed that indicates, yes, we plan to do this. And we have to kind of, you know, you have to be able to demonstrate that what you're working on to make that happen. Those declaration letters have to be signed by November 16th. Now, I don't know if the governor's office is going to say we want to wait until after the election. If so, that probably means it's too late. It would be too late in November 16th to really be able to certify by January of 2013 that we're going to be able to do a partnership exchange. But we've started. In fact, I just came back from a meeting with our NAIC colleagues in Washington where we've looked at the two functions that you could keep hold of, retain the control over, if you're a state partnership exchange. So there are five core functions of exchanges: the plan management, consumer assistance, eligibility, enrollment, and financing. Federal government, HHS, has said you can do plan management and consumer assistance. And then the federal government would retain the other three functions: financing, eligibility, and enrollment. But we need to begin that planning process needs to keep moving forward. What we just did in Washington is develop some white papers that could help guide states if they want to be a partnership state in performing those plan management functions. But there's a lot of detail yet to be worked out there as well.
So if I understand you correctly, if we want to be a partnership exchange with the federal government, that allows us to control certain aspects of the exchange, but two of the five. But we have to certify our intention to take that route by November the 16th, and that requires a letter of declaration from the governor.
Or the HHS has indicated that if you're a statewide elected commissioner, they would consider you having sufficient authority to do that. But I think the climate in Kansas with the opposition to the Affordable Care Act, I'm not sure I want to exercise that ability to sign that declaration letter. I would rather us, if we're going to move forward, I would rather us move forward with maybe not the blessing of the governor's office, but at least no opposition.